December 13th. It hasn't snowed since the last time, but I'm out here with my buddy Kevin. He's on his Defender. We're gonna go for a little ride today in the snow. That's the 800 Defender. Defender's crew, like a 6-passenger. That thing's way cool. I like it a lot. I got the trusty old Can-Am X3. XDS Max. Still got the ITP Ultracross R-Specs on. I really want to get some Bud Light XXLs or some Kryptides, ITP Kryptides, for riding out here in the snow. Probably wait till next year to do that. These are doing pretty good. These Ultracrosses do pretty good. Kevin's got the big horns, just the stock big horn 2.0s on his. I can't remember what size they are, probably a 27 inch. Hopefully he's in 4x4. He's struggling a little bit there. Oh yeah. You lose that momentum, man, it's over. This is windblown snow here, so it's got a little more texture to it. Cruising along 11 miles an hour, 4,000 RPMs. Miles an hour now. Man, I love that windshield. Today, I rolled the top up, get a little sunshine on me. I can't remember, is this where that Jeep, where I had to take over that Jeep, I think. Oh yeah, Kevin is working that Defender out. It's all about the wheel spinning, baby. If I had me some ITP Kryptides, be hooking up like crazy. Or some Mud Light XXLs, 30 inch. That's what I used to run on the Can-Am Renegade XXC, was run the ITP Mud Light XLs. That thing would hook up in the snow. It was way fun. Oh, we gotta slow down here. We'll just stay on it. Oh, we might have a stuck situation here. Kevin got, what's that powder? What's that powder, baby? I might have to go first, break the trail for him. Oh yeah, work it, work it, work it, Kev. dozen of this thing, just like, whatever. That's the worst you got? Big deal. We got a little more horsepower to deal with, though, bigger tires. I don't know which tire is better, the Big Horn or this Ultra Cross. I'd probably say this Ultra Cross is hooking up a lot better. Okay, let's see if Kev can make this hill right here. It's trail's broke on it. Gotta just fly right up it. Oh, he's gonna get some dirt. Hook up city right there. Better stay back a little bit. Get some traction. Oh, there's a big old rock right there. Churn that butter. Churn that butter. Listen to that visco lock. Trying to get some traction there. Gotta love the visco, man. Not really. I wish I had the freaking smart locker on this thing. I guess you can buy it for like $1,600. It's a lot of money. I got that torque locker I need to throw in here. Just try it out, see how it does. People say it's good, people say it's bad. I don't know. I'm gonna try it. I'm gonna put it on, give it a whirl. See how she does. Up here, there's a big old herd of elk running. This was all covered in snow right here. Look at that thing just spinning out. How's that?
I was a little worried if I was going to make it or not.
You made it. All right. We made it about as far as we could make it. This is Ashley Gorge here. It's a beautiful lookout. We're going to keep riding along the rim here. Kicked up about 10 deer so far. Not much braking action going on in this snow. Just slide. There we go. Got the runaway truck ramp here. It's good service we're providing for the critters. Make them a little trail they can walk along easily. There we go. Check that out. Holy cow. That is cool right there. Need to get a picture of that. Take another picture. That is cool. Pretty stuff. I don't think too much lives down in there this time of year. It is too cold. Not enough sunshine. Should we keep going?
I'm with you.
Uh-oh. I think little Kev got stuck. Kev got stuck. Oh man, he's buried. We got us a situation. Deep. Got us a situation. Is it coming out? We got us a situation. We're gonna try this old super winch out, see if it works again. And he is stuck to the frame. Hold on. on a backup. Yeah, I wouldn't have got to you. That was so deep.
The body wouldn't break through.
Yeah. Well, we got him out. Now we're headed back down the trail. This looks interesting. There's a fence line.